heat of the day being over, we prepared to set out to walk to Tent House, to renew our stock of provisions, and endeavor to bring the geese and ducks to our new residence. But, instead of going by the coast, we proposed to go up the river till we reached the chain of rocks, and continue under their shade till we got to the cascade, where we could cross and return by Family Bridge. This was approved, and we set out. Fritz decorated with a beautiful belt of skin, Jack in his porcupine helmet. Each had a gun and game bag, except Francis, who, with his pretty fair face, his golden hair, and his bow and quiver, was a perfect Cupid. My wife was loaded with a large butter pot for a fresh supply. Turk walked before us with his coat of mail, and Flora followed, keeping at a respectful distance from him for fear of the darts. Nips, as my boys called the monkey, finding this new saddle very inconvenient, jumped off with many contortions, but soon fixed on Flora, who, not being able to shake him off, was compelled to become his palfrey. The road by the river was smooth and pleasant. When we reached the end of the wood, the country seemed more open, and now the boys, who had been rambling about, came running up out of breath. Ernest was holding a plant with leaves and flowers and green apples hanging on it. "Potatoes," said he. "I am certain they are potatoes." "God be praised," said I. "This precious plant will secure provision for a colony."